Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies like me. And in this video, I want to make it the easiest video on YouTube on how to make a child theme for your website. And some people completely overcomplicate this whole thing, and it shouldn't be that complicated at all. Now, let me just take 30 seconds to talk about why you want a child theme. It's a good best practice to have a child theme on your website. So the way it works is you have your parent theme, and if you change anything in that parent theme, and then there's an update to the parent theme, all your changes as far as code and custom styles, they all get completely wiped out, and that's why you have this thing called a child theme. So the child theme is linked to the parent, just in like in life, when there's a child is dependent upon the parent for their existence. It's the same thing with a child theme and a parent theme. That child theme is dependent upon the parent theme for its existence. Now, you want a child theme so you can put your customizations inside the child theme, and that makes all of your customizations upgrade safe. So now when there's an update to your parent theme, you can update it and you don't lose any of your code customizations. Now for me on my website, I have extensive code customizations. I love the theme that I bought for my website, but it wasn't everything that I wanted it to be, so I changed it over time. And I can comfortably change anything on this theme and know when there's an update, I'm gonna be safe. So let me show you how to do this. Now, I did make a YouTube video on how to do this about a year ago. It's a wildly popular video, over 100,000 views on it, but I wanted to just redo this video. So we're gonna create this child theme using a plugin to create it, and it's so easy to use. So I'm logged into WordPress, and I'm gonna go to plugins, add new, and we're going to download and install this plugin. So first of all, let's just type child theme. And this is going to show us all the different plugins that are available that are related to child themes. Now I'm going to use this one here. It's called the Child Theme Configurator, and it's currently active on 100,000 sites. Now when we use this plugin to create a child theme, you can then disable and delete the plugin. So you don't have to have it on your website forever. It does have some useful utilities that make it nice and convenient, but you don't have to have it. Now my old video, I think I was using this one-click child theme, and that's a good one as well, but this one makes the process smoother. So let me click on install now, and then I'm going to go ahead and activate it. Now, the way we use this plugin is there's a new option underneath tools. So you can go to tools and then child themes right here. Now, let me tell you the problem with the other plugin and why I am now recommending using this plugin. There is some challenges you could face when you put a child theme on an existing website where you've already customized your menus and you may have customized some things in the customizer. Now, what happens is if you just install a child theme, WordPress sees it as a different theme. So all those menus you put in different locations, they're not going to be there anymore. All those widgets you put in different locations, they're not going to be there anymore. And all those customizations, they're not going to be there anymore either. And that's a big problem. And that was causing some problems for some people. What this plugin does a little better is that it takes those widgets and menus and customizations you made and it throws them into the child theme for you. And it makes it so easy. So we're going to first go right here and we're going to click on create a new child theme. And then right here, we need to choose what the parent theme is. Now, I actually have three themes installed on this site because I use it for testing. This is the active theme right now, so I'm going to choose that. So that's the theme I want to make a child theme for. So first, I'm going to click on Analyze. And then here, we're going to just follow a couple more steps. So first of all, we are going to give the theme a folder name, and we can just choose the default. Typically, you want the name of the parent theme, hyphen, and then it'll just say child, and so that makes it real easy. So you can just leave that the same. Here's another option, number 5. We're just going to keep this one checked here that says primary style sheet. And then when we scroll down, actually all these we're pretty much going to keep the defaults, but I do want to talk about it. And here's an option for the style sheet handling. We're going to leave that the same. Now here on option 7, this is where you might want to change it a little bit. So when I go here, you can actually give the child theme a different name. It could be just the name of the parent theme and the word child, or you can name it whatever the heck you want. And there's usually a link to where this theme can be found, and you can put whatever you want. You can change the author name, you can change the author website, and the description. Let me actually show you where that shows. So I'm going to open this in a new tab. So if I'm right here and I click on theme details, that's this here, the name, by, the author name, the link, and this little bit of text here. Well, that's what it's giving you an option to change here. So if you want to, you can change it or just leave it the same. I say just leave it the same. Okay, so I'm going to scroll down a little bit here. Now here's what you want to do. You want to check on this box. And so right here it's saying copy menus, widgets, and other customizer settings from the parent theme to the child theme. This one option here makes this a very smooth process. So then go ahead and click on create new child theme, and it really only takes a second. And now we have all these different options here. So I'm going to come back to this plugin. So let's now go to appearance and then themes, and you're going to see here's my parent theme, but here is that new child theme. And then I can just go ahead and click on activate. And now the child theme is activated and you can see the parent theme there. Now you can't delete the parent theme. It is dependent upon the parent theme. The parent theme needs to be there. This is just so you could take your code customizations and you can throw them in a child theme so everything's upgrade safe. Now let me show you a couple of cool more things about this plugin and what I like about it. Now a lot of times, okay, let me actually first go to appearance and then editor. And then let me show you all the files in that parent theme. So I'm going to choose primer and click on select. So the parent theme has all these files. Now, if you wanted to say customize this theme footer file, if you did it in the parent theme, it's going to be overwritten when there's another update. So now the thing is, wow, we've got this great child theme. Now, how do we actually take this theme footer file and make a copy that is in the child theme? Now for me it's easy. I know exactly how to log into the file systems and duplicate and move and do all that stuff, but it might be a little bit of a geeky nerdy thing, so it's not so non-techie. It gets a little techie at that point, but that child theme creator plugin makes this process easy. So I can go to tools and go back into the plugin settings right here. And I can choose right here where it says files. And so here's all the files in my parent theme. I can click on any file I want and it will make a copy of it in the child theme. And then I can go in and change any code I want. So for me, I might want to take that footer file. So I would click right there and then click copy to the child theme. And it made a copy of it. And now if I wanted to customize that file, I could go to appearance and then editor. And here it is, theme footer, that file, and it's right there. Now it's copied into the child theme, and it's super easy to make any code modification that you want. If you want to add a theme function, you could do it right here. If you wanted to add some kind of style sheet, you could do it here. Now, here's the deal. You might go into creating a website thinking, I'm never going to change anything. I'm not going to change the code. I'm not going to change the style. I don't know how to do that, nor do I think I'm going to need to do it. But let me tell you, you're going to find out that when you have a website for a little while, you're going to find, I want to change that. Let me ask the maker of that plugin. And the maker of the plugin is going to come back and say, hey, take this custom function and put it in your functions file. And that's when you realize that you need a child theme. And so that's where you can come in here and put it in this theme functions file and have it all be upgrade safe. If you're doing any e-commerce with the plugin WooCommerce, you're going to need some custom functions to be able to do the custom things that you want to do. And if there's any aspect of your website that you might want to be a different color and the theme developer doesn't make it easy, well, that's going to be custom code. It's actually not that complicated, but the reason you have a child theme is so that you have it in there in an upgrade safe manner. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.